On the food scene tonight, we have Chef Shawne Shell from The Hare and the Hound and Landrum in the kitchen with us to talk about some easy meals that you can make, perfect for the summertime, easy cleanup. I like it.
I like it too. And again, this is something that's, you can do so many different things as far as, cooking with full.
And full packets.
And full packets. And again, you can cook these either in the oven, you can do them on the grill, and you can even do them right on the campfire.
I like this. So you have a couple different options. What are we going to start with today?
Today we're going to start with a salmon one, which is actually really simple. One thing I do want to tell you, and what you want to do is you want to make sure that you always go ahead and spray with a little bit of nonstick spray the foil.
You don't want all your food to get stuck to the foil pack.
Exactly.
Right?
And then what we're going to do, this one is going to have potatoes, salmon, and asparagus. And it's going to have a little bit of garlic with it as well. We're going to start off, these are just shoestring yellow potatoes.
Already pre-cut shoestring.
Already pre-cut. We're going to put those right there, and we're going to put our salmon right there on the top of it.
Do you season the salmon?
Yeah, you can. Matter of fact, I've got a little bit of salt and pepper.
But you don't go crazy because it's all going
to get. You want the salmon to have its own flavor, but a little salt and pepper never hurt.
A little salt and pepper in there.
And then what we're going to do is we're going to take just a little bit of garlic, and we're going to move that around there real quick.
And you've seen these videos floating around online of people doing these foil packets, so I wanted to know how easy they really
are. And again,
to do.
This is, it's so simple. And again, I bake these in the oven generally about 400 degrees for about 12 to 15 minutes, and they're done. And again, at this point, we're good. But you always got to have a little bit of butter or
a little oil
in there. So we're going to put that right there. And the next part is to fold. And what I find is easy is to roll to the middle. And
hot dog.
And pull this back. And I always do the birthday fold on the end there. It just makes it easier.
Okay.
And then you want to seal this off. You want to leave a little bit of room for convection. And then what I do on the ends is I fold one direction and another, and then tuck it under.
Tuck it under.
So, and again, you got to fold it almost like folding a flag. And then you just put that right under there.
Put it in the oven.
And it's ready to go.
And then when you pull it out, it turns out like this one
on the
end.
It's right here.
And again, That's the way it came out. We have about 1 minute to do the last one.
What we're going to do is we're going to do an Asian version. And again, this is done with cod. These are just some shoestring veggies. Mm-hmm. They're going to go on the bottom. We're going to take our cod there.
Do you cook this longer than the other one? Or?
This one, you want to. It all depends on the size of the fish and the thickness of the fish. This one right here, I want to do a little bit of lime with it. And then you can use any kind of pre-made teriyaki.
Kind of give it a little spice there with the sesame.
Exactly. And then again, we'll fold this one to the middle.
And then that one turns out looking like this one. You can add some toppings or whatever else you want to add to it.
Same thing with side items. I mean, if you want to do rice, you can do rice. You can actually take your own potatoes, put a little bit of butter in there, throw those on the grill, and you have ready-made potatoes to go with your own.
Kids can help you do it.
And that's the best part of it.
You added some rice to the sesame one, some salsa to give it a little spice as well.
And again, you can even make kids, wrap their own meal, whatever they like. If they like a hot dog, or if they like, whatever, they can.
They can do that, have their own little package.
Share it with the family.
Chef Shawne, thank you so much. Go visit him at The Hare and the Hound, thehareandhound.com. Up in Landrum, they're always serving it up there. Thank you so much for joining us on the food scene tonight,
You're
Chef Shawne. Good eats.